używaliśmy ruchu i my Polacy też nie używaliśmy ruchu stronia, natomiast to było takie pierwsze zetknięcie cywilizacyjne z ideą uczestnictwa ruchu koronnego. Przedtem w Polsce używało się tylko i wyłącznie and were born novel from the start, if you were a kid, you have to know how to ride a horse, you have to know how to find fence with a saber, you have to know how to use the bow and the arrows. And everybody did it. Every kid did it. So there's no reason to write a book about it, because everybody did it done. You know, do it. And this is where you can always also see, you know, in a couple of books like Explore Classic, you can find the description why there are no sources about it, because everybody knows it. So when we, as a Forest Production Association Fund, were trying to look for sources, we cannot find it in Holland, we have to use the books from Turkey or Arabic. Interesujący jest brak polskich źródeł z XV-XVI wieku na temat używania łuku wschodu, na temat technik, jak to się zrobiło. Bardzo dużo jest źródeł na ten temat w krajach arabskich, bardzo dużo jest źródeł na ten temat w Turcji, natomiast w Polsce nie ma żadnych, ale to nie dotyczy tylko
status nie tylko do używania.
nagrywania, że status władzy, łuk i tutaj widoczny z tyłu, łuk refleksyjny i charakterystyczny kołczan, także to jest chyba zrobić wszystko, prawda? Zrobił też na Wałce Stokholmskim, czyli takim bardzo znanym obrazie przedstawiającym wejście Króla Polskiego do Sztokholmu w całym takim warunku. Też widać, że większość ludzi ma tutaj łuki wielkiego włosu. So these are also the paintings which are proof to us that postcard culture were used very common, not only as a military weapon, but also as a symbol of status. We have a hetman here wearing a characteristic Turkish type quiver and quiver bow. And this painting is from a very famous painting called Roka Sztokholmska, Sztokholm Roka. This is just a small piece of a bigger painting which shows the parade of Polish king entering Stockholm in the 17th century. And you can see the Polish nobles shooting arrows. Okay, so one of the things we do in association, besides organizing competitions, workshop, and introducing postcard archery in Poland, is also the historical reenactment. This is Michał Poczaj wearing a 17th century light cavalry outfit, and from time to time he also participates in battles as a postcard archer, as a light cavalry, doing also a martial. Jedną rzecz, którą robimy jako stowarzyszenie, jest także udział w różnych organizacjach historycznych, czyli próba jakby pokazania w taki sposób bardzo żywy, jak kiedyś wyglądała polska technika wojskowa, jak wyglądało życie łuku, konia, panna, szabli i wszystkich rzeczy. Okay, so a bit about our association now. I think right now we have 63 active members, participants in the Horseback Archery Association, including 5 honorary members. There is only one organization in Poland that supports our association. During the competition, we have more or less 60 members, active members participating. It doesn't mean that all of the association members are competing. So let's say there are people not in the association who competes, and some of the members of the association, like myself, doesn't compete, but are active and they're trying to introduce postcard archery in Poland. It all started from one meeting, and this is the 10th anniversary of this year. This meeting is called Żurawiki. I will speak about it a bit more soon. Okay, so we have like 5-6 competitions per year, and about 10 to 12 horseback archery seminars in Poland. Also during winter, we have a couple archeries, traditional archery seminars where we learn to teach people how to use the sunring and very good bow. Okay, interesting point about Poland, we have 100% of the Polish postbacher archers are using the tambourine technique. So, no, I don't know any Polish competitor who is using the vegetarian style. Czyli jeszcze troszeczkę o naszym stowarzyszeniu.
start from a point with zero turbulence and back, shooting as many arrows as you can to the front and then escaping to the back. So it's a pretty interesting competition, but pretty hard if you don't have your own horse or if you don't have a horse who is positioning well. So this is a unique competition for Poland. And of course, famous the Polish style, which started, I think, already 5 years ago while training in the forest, when you have different targets, different places, and you don't get like a horse, but you have to turn, you have to do some moves. It will be a seminar next week, just right after the competition. Next Monday there will be a workshop just for Polish driving for 50 kilometers from here for a